Then, at 10 o'clock, I do this. It's important to move every 3 hours or so, otherwise the rat gets too bold, thinks you've croaked, and starts biting. Not today, buddy. At around noon, it's lunch, so I go like this. Then, I like to look at things and think about what they taste like. The rug would taste of peach fruit roll-up, and the TV would taste of burnt creme caramel set in a rich Highland double fudge base.
Okay, I think since it's Bring Your Child to Work Day in our class, we might want to choose another parent. What do you say, Mom?
No!
But why? We want to see the Rainbow Factory!
It'll be the best day ever! First, we'll watch the happy little elves whistling their merry tunes as they dig for color in the rainbow mines.
Then we'll see all the colors being mixed in the palette by dancing unicorns!
Then we'll hear the singing of the orange munchkins as they churn it with their magic machines! And then we pause for a couple of hours for lunch. And then...
You only get an hour for lunch.
Oh.
Then we have to share between 50 people. And I said no! I look like I've been thrown into space without a spacesuit.
Please take us!
No! We'll pay you $10.
Can we have $10?
I said no!
Because the CEOs are coming down to decide whether to close the factory and give everyone their pink slip.
A pink slip? Like a magic ticket?
Yeah, a magic ticket to unemployment and depression. So you guys are going to stay with your father and do whatever it is he does.
Ah, please. Hanging out with Dad on his workday is like watching a ripe avocado turn into guacamole with just the force of gravity.
I get your point, but I can't have you there today.
I gotta run. If I'm much later, I'll be back for dinner before I get to work.
Wait! Briefcase! Oh, boy. Thank you, sweetheart.
Good morning, gentlemen.
I'm so sorry I'm late. I worked all night on these figures, and I can assure you there's absolutely no need to close the factory.
We are the shareholders.
Oh, sorry, right. And you are?
Objects, Watterson. They're inanimate objects.
Right.
Now, please, give us the stats.
Oh, yes, of course. I'm sorry, I've left them on my desk.
If you're not back in 2 minutes, we'll move your desk to a bathroom stall.
I know you mean that as a threat, but as we're not allowed to take bathroom breaks, it would technically be an improvement.
Give me those! Are you kidding me? How on earth could you be in there? You handed me the briefcase yourself!
Yes, but from the inside. Oh, wait! Your briefcase! Oh, boy! Thank you, sweetheart.
I'm going back to the meeting. Meanwhile, you're going to stay here and touch nothing. Have I made myself clear?
I said nothing.
Oh, no! She dropped some important stuff, giving us the perfect excuse to look for her and check out the factory in the process.
But she told us to stay here.
Darwin, all it takes for bad things to happen is for good people to do nothing.
I don't think we count as good people.
Then all it takes for good things to happen is for bad people to do something.
Oh. No.
What?
I'm totally convinced.
Let's find out how they put these magic colors in the sky.
With unicorns and pixies, candy cane and apple pie.
I used to think that they were caused by how the light refracts.
But now I'm sure it's magical, so who are we gonna ask?
Hey!
Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Hello, friend. Now tell me, are you elf or are you gnome?
Neither, kid. The lack of daylight stunted every bone.
And is this color made from lemonade and fairy dust?
It's gasoline and arsenic and latex, lead, and rust.
Hey!
Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet.